There's always that awkward stage between console generations when games are straddling two or more systems and are thus inevitably hampered by the lowest common denominator. In order to reach as many people as possible, games can be subdued to work everywhere, and are then not taking full advantage of newer, more powerful hardware.
What could possibly go wrong?
Ratchet and Clank Rift Apart is not one of these games.
Well, that's good news.
Rift Apart is the latest in the long Ratchet and Clank series from Insomniac Games. The last game in 2016 was a reimagined remake of the original from 2002. It also served as a tie-in for a movie nobody saw.
That's a bummer.
But this game is all new, fresh, and very fun. In Rift Apart, you play as both Ratchet and Rivet, his interdimensional counterpart. After Dr. Nefarious attacks a parade and steals a Dimensionator Clank build to help Ratchet find other Lombaxes...
Huh?
If you're new to the series, here's a note. They make up words. Don't question it. Shut up. Have fun. After the Dimensionator is destroyed, rifts open as portals into other dimensions. Ratchet and Clank end up separated, and Clank is found by Rivet. You switch between Ratchet and Rivet as they try to rebuild the Dimensionator and stop the rifts, defeating Emperor and Dr. Nefarious.
There's two!
The core gameplay of Ratchet and Clank hasn't really changed in about 20 years. It's a fast, fun, cartoony third-person shooter with lots of weapons and loads of things to shoot. Rift Apart introduces a new mechanic, aptly named Rifts. These portals scatter generally around combat areas at a strategic verticality to your movements. Getting blocked in by some enemy robot pirates? Zip to the portal behind them. They're also helpful in the various puzzles you run into along the way, as well as collecting all the collectibles there are to collect. But these portals are just a taste of the showstopper of Rift Apart. At various times, Ratchet or Rivet can hit Phase Quartz, a sort of interdimensional crystal that then transports them completely to a different dimension, immediately, in real time. To do this, both completely rendered worlds are available at the same time. This is where the power of the PlayStation 5's memory comes in. By having super fast memory drives, these worlds can be switched at will, with absolutely zero load times. This is immediately highlighted at the beginning of the game as Ratchet quickly travels through multiple dimensions in real time, not a cutscene. Now this would be simple if, say, only one room or building was changing, but this is the whole entire map. Some games have done the version of this in the past, but not at this scale, and certainly not as smoothly and seamlessly as this.
Anyone? Anyone seen this before? The Laffer curve. Anyone know what this says? It says that at this point on the revenue curve, you will get exactly the same amount of revenue as at this point. This is very controversial. Does anyone know what Vice President Bush called this in 1980? Anyone? Something D-O-O economics. Voodoo economics.
It's super powerful and neat, okay? And it definitely shows why this simply couldn't work on older hardware. If people said Ghost of Tsushima would make a PS4 Pro sound like it was about to take off, Rift Apart would make them say it just laughed at them.
And it exploded.
And it's lucky a PS4 can't even try, because Rift Apart is obviously incredibly beautiful. The smooth and steady 60 frames is solid through and through.
And Jesus wept.
There's an available ray tracing and 4K resolution. The lighting, textures, animations are all impeccably detailed and beautifully rendered.
Jesus wept!
Stop saying Jesus wept.
It genuinely does look better than the movie nobody saw 5 years ago, so that's impressive. The story is also very fun. Rivet and Kit, the newest members of the pack, are real and dimensional. And the worlds you travel to are varied and diverse, filled with interesting and weird creatures, some of them with Midwestern accents for some reason.
Now these jerks will really find out who they're messing with, don't you know? Mush, please!
Okay then.
Okay then.
Okay then.
And the vast array of weapons is indeed vast. Some are somewhat run-of-the-mill pistol shotgun video game standards, but others are incredibly silly and creative, like the Pixelator, which turns what you're shooting at into a pixelated bit character complete with old 8-bit sound effects. There's also the Rhino 8, which opens portals into other PlayStation franchises like Horizon Zero Dawn and Uncharted.
Cross-promotional, deal mechanics, revenue streams, jargon, synergy.
The DualSense controller is also working hard, accentuating every trigger pull with realistic resistance and vibration. And of course, there's dozens of upgrades available for every weapon, from reduced cooldown times to increased ammo. Even when you start a new game plus, there's even more upgrades, which encourages replays, making more bang for your buck, which I am always a fan of.
You take this home, throw it in a pot, add some broth, a potato, baby, you got a stew going.
You know, there's so much in this world right now that is complicated and difficult and frustrating and scary and just awful. Ratchet and Clank is none of those things. This game is just fun. It's beautiful, it uses the DualSense controller haptics incredibly, and it's just a good time. The difficulty levels are broad, so it's tougher if you want it to be. It's a movie if you don't. With all the crap in the world right now, we have an incredible game, made impeccably well. Not to mention the lack of crunch it took to get here, showing that great games can be made ethically and still efficiently. The only downside is it's a PS5 exclusive, and those are still pretty hard to find right now. But I tell you, when you do finally get your hands on one, you'll have an absolute joy to play first. That'll be jumping out of the box, asking,
"Who wants to have some fun?"
I do.
Now, are you just saying you want to have fun, or do you really want to have fun?
I really want to have fun. I'm just saying I want to have some fun.